notice, we have in the pipeline more than 80 cases dealing with apprenticeship and training programs. And what we find are there's a lack of written procedures about fees and expenses. There's a lack of internal expense controls. We find widespread misuse, misappropriation of plan assets. You know, the kinds of trustee expenses and staff expenses that you'd never see in a pension fund or a health and welfare fund. It appears that in some cases the same trustees sit on all these funds, and all the expenses that are disallowed under the pension fund and the health and welfare fund are put through the apprenticeship fund. These are serious violations, and I want to plead with you to police yourselves, to go back and look at your apprenticeship and training programs and make sure that they are in compliance with ERISA. These are very serious concerns that we have. And I want you all to be on notice that we're going to go after them. You know, when I was nominated, and I was lucky, I was considered an uncontroversial nominee. It still took them 4 months to confirm me. But I had to meet with all the Republican staff. And question after question after question went like this. Do you intend to go after collectively bargained plans, which of course they call union plans, just like with the same kind of vigor that you go after corporate plans, that you meaning the department? And what I said to them and what I say to you is, when we find violators, we're going to go after you. And it doesn't matter if you are a labor trustee, a management trustee, a service provider, the administrator of the fund, a staff member. We just got a consent decree with a staff member of an apprenticeship and training fund who had embezzled over a series of 5 or 6 years more than $1 million. Nobody was watching over that staff person. So I'm begging you to please try to pay more attention to these funds, and because if you don't, we're going to investigate and we're going to prosecute. So.